themselves. Well, new at 5, what can make someone living in the country an American citizen turn to terrorism? Eyewitness News reporter Miriam Hernandez put that question to some experts.
Neighbors in the Inland Empire never saw it coming.
You'd never know who your neighbors are.
The suspects were legal U.S. residents. 2 were American citizens. According to a federal complaint, they were ready to abandon what seemed to be a comfortable life in suburbia to resort to radical acts. But why?
It's only through a very intimate knowledge of the person who's in front of you when you're talking to him and you're investigating him that you can find out really what motivates him.
Amos Brandis is the former chief of security for the Israeli Airlines El Al. He specializes in predictive profiling. An inclination to terrorism, he says, can be uncovered through skilled questioning.
When you interview someone, you can push buttons, we call it.
He says a red flag may be uncovered by asking a person if he would take a job, even if it would mean a pay cut. For a military applicant,
I want to go and I want to work in this agency because I want to kill people, or because I want to kill those who want to kill me. I mean, the idea is that they go immediately to the extreme.
Brandis says homegrown terrorists can be well-educated. Take the case of Patrick Arguello.
He went to UCLA. He was a medical doctor. He graduated. He was a Fulbright scholar.
In Europe, Arguello joined a Palestinian terror group. He was shot hijacking a plane. Ana Montes, born in Topeka, was a U.S. intelligence specialist. Now she's in prison for espionage. Terror leaders, he says, are typically driven by ideology or religion. The people they recruit, though, often have a different trait involving their self-image.
But it was ego that drove those people to do something against their organization or against their country.
Miriam Hernandez, ABC 7, Eyewitness News.